It hasn't been a popular topic until now. It's called the achievement gap, a measure of why students of color underperform in school, at least some of them. Today, State School Superintendent Jack O'Connell convened a statewide summit to look for solutions. And here's KCRA3's Kevin Riggs.
It was a packed house at Sacramento's Convention Center, in the halls, on the main floor.
If the school is effective, poor kids do a lot of catching up.
More than 4,000 educators here from across the state to talk about a touchy topic, why white students perform better in school than Latino or African American students. It's known as the achievement gap.
It has a lot to do with both the race and the economic status.
Dolores Coates teaches 7th grade math in South Central Los Angeles. Historically, she says, the achievement gap has not been talked about publicly.
It has been quietly discussed among not only the teachers, the districts, and the administration, but we have seen this problem escalate.
You did.
Escalating to the point, says California's schools chief, that it can no longer be ignored.
I'm not surprised at the interest in the achievement gap. I mean, it's real, it's persistent, it's stark, and it really does need to be addressed. The research, the data is crystal clear. It clearly shows that students of color, students are learning the English language, significantly lag behind their peers.
At least two or three more.
Finding solutions while maintaining high expectations is the goal of this gathering.
I believe that because of the breakdown of the family unit, because parents are spending less time with their kids, that's the real reason why we don't see the successes we used to in our educational system.
You can't point fingers and blame families and blame students.
I modeled 4, 5, and 6.
Families in poverty, Ducheney notes, are struggling to pay bills, but spending more is an unlikely option given the state's shaky revenues. Dolores Coates believes the answer has to come from home.
School does not just stop at when the bell rings at 3 o'clock.
Kevin Riggs, KCRA 3 reports.
Kevin also reports that Superintendent O'Connell told educators he should be held accountable if there is no progress toward reducing the achievement gap before he leaves office.